Hi, once again welcome back to Obstetrics and Gynecological videos. Today we are going to see about the abnormalities of puparia. Here, particularly in this video, we are going to discuss about the psychiatric disorders that you can see commonly in the puparial period or in the postnatal period. First, before going to the psychiatric disorders or psychological problems, we should know what is happening to the mother psychologically in the postnatal period or after delivery. What are the psychological changes that are happening to a lady that we should see? The psychological changes that is occurring or the major events that is occurring in the postnatal period include taking in phase, taking hold phase and letting go phase. Taking in phase means in the first 2-3 days the woman will be passive, and this is a period where she is regaining her physical strength and she is calming up her thoughts. That is, we know that labor process means it's a process with severe pain, and she will be having that shock and she will be just recovering from that shock and pain. So that process is happening in the first 2 to 3 days, and along with that pain and sudden withdrawal of hormones, all those things are there. Along with that, she will be having a role change also. That is, she is supposed to take care of a new baby. And if the mother is a primipara mother, she may be totally unaware of the baby care, breastfeeding, all those things. This also may be a tension producing factor for her. So she will be in the middle of all these things in the first 2-3 days. And usually she won't do any work. Most probably she will be passive and she will be in the bed. Even for her own work, even for toileting and other things, she may seek the help of others. And next is taking hold phase. It starts after 3 days. Gradually or slowly, she will start to take care of herself. She will start to take care of the baby. She will learn how to feed the baby. And she will learn how to take care of the baby, all those things. And this is the best time for you to give education about the baby care and about her own care. And the last phase is letting go phase. That is, she will totally accept her new role and changes in her body, everything. She will start to take care of herself completely and she will start to take care of her baby also fully. But in certain cases, these three normal phases will not occur. Instead of that, the lady may remain in the first stage itself. That is, in a passive stage, they may remain. Otherwise, they may go to a depression or other psychiatric disorders. So we are going to see those things one by one. First one is postpartum blues, or it is otherwise known as baby blues. And its onset is within 3 to 5 days after the delivery. Usually in the first 3 days, I told you that lady will be in a passive stage. So we may not even notice that whether she is having depression. All will be in an almost same stage. Slightly depressed, not taking part in any activity, not taking care of even her own body. That stage will be there for the first 3 days. But if it is persisting after 3 days, after 5 days also, we are calling it as postpartum blues. The features will be, she will be having crying spells without any reason. She may cry. Emotional liability will be there. Irritability will be there. Sometimes she may be crying. Sometimes she may get irritated. And she will be having excessive anxiety. The anxiety may be about her own body or about the prognosis of her future, or about her future delivery, or sometimes it may be about the baby care, or sometimes maybe about the breastfeeding. Like, so many factors may be there. And the next one is hypochondriasis. That is, excessive anxious stage is known as the hypochondriasis. Management include, first you should reassure the mother and you should educate her the normal physiological changes that is happening in the postnatal period. You should teach her how to take care of the baby, how to breastfeed, baby care, postnatal care, everything you should teach, including postnatal exercises you should teach her. And you should monitor for the mother for the resolutions or for the changes. And the family members and other relatives also should offer her proper support. The family support, that itself will relieve or manage the problem. Next is postpartum depression. That is, the lady will go to from the postnatal blues. That is normal. It's okay for everyone. Most of the mothers will get the postnatal blues. But if she is going to a stage of depression, that is different. The lady will be having depressed mood. anhedonia will be there, that is inability to experience pleasure. Usually when the baby is sucking or when the baby is moving, when the baby is smiling, the lady will experience a pleasure, but she won't be having the capacity to experience that pleasure. She will be having guilt feeling, hopelessness, suicidal thoughts may be there, thought of harming even the infant, that feeling also may be there. The predisposing factors include, if the mother is having the family or personal history of depression, in the previous history, in her own past history, if she got the past history of depression, the chance for recurrence is more. And in her family, if someone is having the history of depression, in that case also the chance for occurrence is more. And already if the lady is having bipolar disorder or anxiety disorder, in that case also the chance is more. And if she is not having proper social support, especially if it is an unwanted pregnancy or if the pregnancy is after a rape attempt, in those cases, or if it is an illegal pregnancy, in that cases the chance for depression is more. And if it is a history of sexual or physical abuse, or if the lady is having the habit of cigarette smoking or alcoholism, or if she is having occupational or financial or other health problems, in these cases, the chance for occurrence of depression is more. And already if she is having the history of taking antidepressants, and if she is discontinuing the antidepressants all of a sudden, in that case also, there is a chance for occurrence of the depression in the postnatal period. And the risk of untreated depression includes, usually these ladies may not breastfeed the baby properly, and due to the improper breastfeeding, the baby may get poor growth, and failure to thrive, and sometimes it may affect even the IQ level of the children. If the baby is not getting proper nutrients and vitamins, the brain development may get affected, and initially the mother's care is needed for that warmness, care, everything is needed for the psychological and for the mental growth of the baby. And there is a chance for marital disharmony if someone is not taking care of the baby, or if the lady is totally away from the family, sometimes the partner may not accept it, and that may lead to the marital disharmony. And later, the child also may get the depression in the future. And the next is management. First, you should collect a detailed history. You should take the family history or personal history of depression, take the history of alcoholism, history of cigarette smoking, and you should ask whether the lady is having the history of any sexual abuse or physical abuses or any health related other problems. Sometimes she may be having some sexual disorders, or that also may lead to the depression, or whether she is having any financial issues. Such detailed history you should take. These are the contributing factors. And if something is there, means it is better to identify earlier, and you should post such cases or send such cases to the counselor. And after the counseling also, if it is not relieving, if the depression is not reducing, you can start the antidepressants. You can give citalopram 10 to 40 milligram or sertralin 10 to 15 milligram. You can give to the mother. It will relieve the condition. And next is postpartum psychosis. Usually it will occur within 3 weeks after the childbirth. The features are delusions, that is false thoughts and beliefs, confusion, agitation. She may get agitated and violent. Sometimes she may harm the others, and sometimes she may harm herself or she may harm her children. And insomnia, lack of sleep, disorganized thinking, all those things will be there. And if such things you have observed, immediately you should refer the case to a psychiatrist, and psychiatric treatment should be taken. That we are not discussing here because already you might have studied in detail in the psychiatry. So thank you for watching the psychiatric disorders that will occur in the puparium. Thank you once again.